Hi, my name is Anissa.
Hi, my name is Gabby.
All right, my name is Dean Harrigy.
Hi, my name is Rubina.
Hi, my name is Mogus Bayen.
I worked with two students. Their names were Veronica and Leonardo. So I would go to the camp twice a week on Mondays and Tuesdays. We would leave campus to get there at about, we would leave campus at 4:15.
I work with Martina and Gabriele. Martina is 9 years old, while Gabriele is 8 years old.
I'm working with Silvano Selimovic, and he is a Roma of 16 years of age.
Student that I've been working with is Angelica. She is 10 years old.
The student that I work with at the Roma camp is Malena Ahmedovic. She's 8 years old.
I work with Mateo Ahmedovic. He's 10 years old and he's a very sweet kid. I love him very much.
So basically what we do with the kids is we work on the literacy skills through the internet.
I worked with them to increase computer literacy because they weren't they didn't know how to work with the computer very well.
We basically try to work on her skills of writing and basic things like knowing her alphabet, since she doesn't seem to know that, unfortunately. I try to use the computer with our work, usually to help her type out letters or words. Sometimes she'll write them in Italian and I'll try to translate them to English so she gets to know both languages.
Basic computer functions like typing or opening programs, opening files, saving a document, how to even open the internet, things like that.
Yesterday, something.
So with these children, a lot of the times they have a big issue with education, and because of that education, they're not able to move forward out of the camp.
Well, culturally speaking, the Roma are looked down upon in the Italian community, and if I'm not mistaken, a good portion of Europe. So they are restricted access to a lot of jobs, opportunities that most of us take for granted. And what we're doing is just fixing a small facet of that, or at least combating against that, in the sense of with education at least fixing that with development.
Well, the kids go to school very randomly. They're not on a consistent schedule with school.
Carol just explained to us that a lot of the kids don't go to school because they feel that they are made fun of because of their situation, because they're gypsy kids, and teachers don't want to spend any time on them. They feel that they're not going to get anywhere because they feel like they're only going to be in this camp situation for the rest of their lives, so they shouldn't pay any attention to them because they're not going to go anywhere.
Since she's 8 years old, she's kind of behind compared to other students, but hopefully through the use of the computer and also through literacy, we can get them to be on the level that other kids would be in.
One of the things, Martina, every time I ask her to write a sentence, let's say, she always writes something to do with, "I hate bad teachers." And she always says, "cattiva." And when I ask her, you know, what does that mean? Or like, what's bad about this teacher? She says that when in her old school, not the one that she's now, but in her old school, her classmates used to sing and dance and they used to read and write, and she was the only one that couldn't read. And the teacher never used to focus and pay attention on her because she simply like left her as almost, it's almost like not threw her away, but almost like she's not worth my time because like all the other kids can read, so why should I waste my time on this one child who's gonna be stuck for the rest of her life?
No,
perché?
Sì. Ci stanno dei bambini che odiano i zingari.
Odiano i zingari?
Sì.
voi vado a scuola, università, or studio?
Però così così.
Così così, ok.
Perché ci sono bambini che mi dicono parolacce e non voglio andare a scuola, così.
Scuola importante?
Sì, normale, è importante scuola, perché se non vanno a scuola, che futuro avranno? Nessuno. Così vanno a scuola, si imparano un po' a scrivere, un po' a leggere, capiscono le cose, come funzionano, come stanno le cose, si imparano, no? Pure in altre lingue possono imparare inglese, francese, italiano, se vogliono studiare, ma se non vogliono studiare, no, non cambia niente, solo...
Cerchiamo di dare un futuro ai nostri figli. La scuola è importante perché aiuta ad integrare, aiuta la lingua italiana a comprendere, perché i bambini comprendono meglio il significato delle parole. Quando stanno in mezzo alla gente sanno di cosa si parla, capiscono bene, quindi si troveranno meno in difficoltà nel futuro ad affrontare anche il mondo del lavoro.
Heard and what we've experienced is the fact that a lot of people think that these kids don't go to school because either they don't want to, or their parents don't send them, or their parents don't care about their kids' education, when in reality the fact is they're afraid of going to school, or they're afraid of being picked at, or they're afraid of bad teachers, let's say, like Martina's a perfect example.
The Roma community are very marginalized. The kids, for instance, Mateo is 10 years old and he doesn't know how to read and write. I don't understand how the school in Italy allows a kid who doesn't know how to read to pass through, to get to fifth grade without knowing all this stuff, all these basic literacy skills.
Although the children that I work with do speak Italian and they were born in Italy, they aren't treated as normal citizens or as normal children would be treated.
Ok, so perché i bambini no sono cittadini italiani, sì? Okay.
Perché non sono cittadini italiani perché il padre che era slavo,
okay,
ha mostrato documento slavo,
okay,
e loro hanno, così hanno scritto, bambini sono stranieri, ma okay, per la legge dovevano dare la cittadinanza italiana perché i bambini sono nati qui e crescono qui.
Sì.
Qui.
Sì.
E questo è il problema, non lo so perché questo.
Senti.
Sì.
Ok, ok.
È molto difficile che danno documenti, non è facile.
Okay.
Anche se sono nati qui, sempre chiedono prima il passaporto. Poi è difficile perché se io non ce l'ho documento italiano,
uh-huh,
se non sono cittadina italiana io, prendono la cittadinanza come Jugoslavia, che sei
uh-huh
nata, come dimostri come padre o madre, da che parte sono.
Sì.
Allora tu dici che sono il paese Jugoslavia,
uh-huh,
e loro mettono straniero.
Il governo che non ci danno questi documenti, perché i bambini se sono nati qua dovranno avere cittadinanza italiana, cioè non possono avere cittadinanza jugoslava perché non sono nati là, non ci sono scritti là, sono residenti qua, cioè a quel punto dovranno vedere loro.
Okay.
I miei bambini sono italiani anche loro, abitiamo qui. Speriamo di integrarci, volevamo integrarci, però ogni volta che proviamo a dare confidenza alla gente, abbiamo molta, la gente ha un po' paura di noi. Perché non conosce i Rom, non conoscono i Rom, le usanze, le tradizioni. Per questo, quando tu non conosci una cosa, hai paura di questa cosa. Però ci dovrebbe essere un collegamento. Le istituzioni dovrebbero far conoscere più le persone Rom, che non sono tutti cattivi.
This is not a problem that can be solved in a year. And this is not a problem with one solution. Unfortunately, we are very far from finding any solutions. However, in our time here, we wanted to get to know the people that everyone says to watch out for. We wanted to know the name of the woman that is begging on the train and understand the mindset and the aspirations of the child that is standing next to her. Above all else, we wanted to get to know the Roma children and develop closer relationships with them. To show them love in a world that has turned its back on them and forgotten about them. We wanted to become their friends and become a part of their life.
se tu fossi il presidente, cosa vorresti fare?
Impedirei le guerre.
Le guerre?
Si poteva viaggiare in qualsiasi parte del mondo, dove vorresti viaggiare?
Nella Finlandia.
E in altro?
In Spagna.
Spagna. Fare di grande.
Lavoro?
Sì.
Voglio fare cucina, grande cucina e fare cucina.
here
to change your opinion.
And each person has the right to their own ideas
and stereotypes.
However, when making judgments,
it is important to always remember
the children.
You have to remember
that the children are not at fault.
And you cannot blame them.
Remembering the children
and keeping an open mind,
free of judgments,
we hope to enter into a better tomorrow
where the endless cycles of
discrimination
can be broken.
And we can make a better life
for our future leaders
of tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Grazie.